will consider this particular graph and we'll see how the Prim's algorithm can be used in order to construct the minimum spanning tree. This is a tracing part. So in the exam or in the internal or in the lab also, during the execution of the Prim's algorithm, if anybody tells you to trace it, write like this the different columns and you can trace the Prim's algorithm. So in this one, assume that I'll consider the vertex 1 as an arbitrary vertex. Any arbitrary vertex you can consider, but here I am considering the vertex 1 as a starting vertex. So next, what we have to do, so these are the tree vertices. Okay, next is the remaining vertex. That means which are the remaining vertices. The remaining vertices are 2 is the remaining vertex, 2 is the remaining vertex. Okay, can you reach the 2 from 1? Yes, I can reach the 2 from 1. That is, I can reach from 1 to 2 with a cost of 1. With a cost of 1. Now, can I reach 3 from the 1? Yes, I can reach the 3 from 1 with a cost of 4. Now, can I reach the 4 from 1? Yes, I can reach the 1 from 4 from 1 with a cost of 8. Now, can I reach the 5 and 6? No, I cannot reach. So, 5 cannot be reached. Okay. So, it is infinity. And 6 cannot be reached. Therefore, it is infinity. Got it? What I did? So, whichever the vertices I can visit from the vertex 1, I have written 1 to 2 with a cost of 1, 1 to 3 with a cost of 4, 1 to 4 with a cost of 8, 5 and 6 I cannot reach from the vertex 1. Therefore, the distance will be an infinity. Now, among these three, you select the path which is the minimum. Or you select the closest vertex, we can say. So, which is the one which is the minimum path? 1, 4, 8. Among 1, 4, 8, which is the minimum? 1 is the minimum. So, the next vertex that what we are selecting will be the 2. The next vertex which one will be I am selecting is the 2. Therefore, 2 will be the vertex which we are selecting in the next iteration, that is 2 from 1 with a cost of 1. So initially nothing will be there. Next, which one I have selected? 1 to 2 I have selected. So it is 1 to 2 with a cost of 1. With a cost of 1. Now write the remaining vertices. 3 is the remaining vertices. Are you having an edge from the 1? Yes, we are having the edge from 1 also, 2 also. But what is the cost? 4 is the cost. So which one will be considered first? 1 to 3 will be considered. Not 2 to 3. As I told you that when we will be implementing, we will go through the matrix entries. When I will go through the matrix entries, 1, 3 will come first before and 2, 3. Therefore, I will select from 1 on 1. 1, 2, 3. What is the cost you are having? That is 4. Cost is the 4. Got it. Next, remaining vertices is 1 is over, 2 is over, 3 is over. Next one is the 4. Next one is the 4. Are you having to the 4 from the vertex any path is there? No. Therefore, I need to consider from 1 only. Okay. How much cost is? 8. Okay. Next, you consider which is the remaining vertex? 5 is the one more remaining vertex what you are having. So, I cannot reach it from the 2. I cannot reach it from the 1. Therefore, it is still infinity. Then 6 also infinity. Because I cannot reach it from 1 and I cannot reach it from the 2. Therefore, both are infinity. Now, among this 4 and 8, which is the minimum? 4 is the minimum. So, the next one which is selecting is the vertex 3 from 1 with a cost of 4. With a cost of 4. And here we will be having 1, 2 and 3. Cost is 4, cost is 1. Okay, noted. So next remaining, this is selected in the next iteration. So this is the illustration what we are writing. So next is remaining vertices are 4, then 5 and 6. These are the remaining vertices what you are having. So now I consider the 4. The can I reach 4 from 1, 2 or 3? No. I can reach it only from the 1, not from 2, not from 3. Therefore, I can reach it only from the, not this one, 4. I can reach it only from the vertex 1, not from the vertex 2 or not from the vertex 3. Therefore, it is 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 4. Cost is again 8. 5. Can I reach the 5 through 3? Yes. I can reach it through 3 with the cost of 3. Okay. Can I reach the 6 from 1, 2, 3? No, I cannot reach. Therefore, the cost here will be an infinity. I cannot reach it. Now, from this, which one you are selecting? 8, 3, infinity. Therefore, it is 1, 1, 2, and 3, and 5. Cost is 3. Here 1, it is 4. Okay. So, next. Minimum is 5 is visited, 4 and 6 are left out, remaining vertices. 4 just now included the vertex 5. Can I reach the 4 from 5? Not possible. So only the path we are having is from the 1 with the cost of 8. Can I reach the 6? Yes, I can reach with the cost of 2. Therefore it is 5 to 6 with the cost of 2. Now which is the minimum among this? 2 is the minimum. So select that one. Are you having now 6 is the visited vertex now? Are you having a path from 6 to 4? Yes. What is the cost? 1. What was the previous path we had? 1 to 4? 8. So which is the minimum? 1 is the minimum. Now I am reaching this from the 6, not from the 1. Okay. From 6 to 4, the cost is 1. Therefore, the final. The final graph what we are getting here is 6, and finally you write one more step. Okay, I am stopping here because there is no place. So this is the tracing for the Prim's algorithm. I have traced around 3 to 4 problems in my notes. You go through my notes. So this is the way how you need to trace the Prim's algorithm. Getting nothing you need to do here. Start with any of the arbitrary vertex. Write down all the remaining vertices. So, if there is a path from the starting vertex to the whichever remaining vertices, you write along with the cost. Then identify which is the one which is with the least cost. That will be an added to your tree vertex. My means 1, 2 is added. 1 and 2 is added. So, in the tree vertex. So, that is the illustration. Then write again the remaining vertices. Now, after adding 2, you check from 1 and 2. From either 1 or from the 2. To any other remaining vertices, if you are having a path, add it. Whichever, suppose 1 is also having a path, 2 is also having a path for a particular vertex, then whichever is the minimum path, you select that minimum path. Again, from this, whichever is minimum, you select. Like that, in the each iteration, what we are doing, we are expanding, or we are expanding the subtree. Each iteration, we are expanding the subtree. That is what I told you. Prim's algorithm will work by expanding the subtree in the each of the iteration by adding one of the vertex to the previous subtree. So this is a tracing for the Prim's algorithm. Go through some few examples are there, and afterwards I'll give the assignment on this also. So that is about Prim's algorithm, and it is your lab program. I will explain you the lab program in detail. Okay. Now we will consider an algorithm that is in Prim's algorithm. Previous session I have explained you about the how to trace the Prim's algorithm and all. So mainly the Prim's will be used for finding the minimum spanning tree for a given graph. Okay. For a given weighted connected graph. Remember that it is for a weighted connected graph. So initially we will consider. So as I told you what we are doing in an Prim's algorithm. Assume that we are having some vertices like this. Okay. So initially VT. VT is nothing but an, it is a visited vertex. Set of visited vertices. So, ET is nothing but an set of edges. Set of edges, okay. So, initially VT. Initially, what is VT? VT is nothing but the vertex, arbitrary vertex, what we are considering. So, assuming that always we will consider the starting vertex as an the vertex from where we are starting our Prim's algorithm. So, initially make the starting vertex. So, maybe A, B or 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it is. So, make the starting vertex, whichever you are considering, as a visited vertex. Now, I will make this as a visited vertex. So, initially what is a set of edges? Set of the edges is null. Means none of the edges selected. Okay. Then, for each of the, for I is equal to n, 1 to n minus 1. What is n? Number of the vertices. So, in this case, it is 1 to 4. N minus 1. So, 1 to 3. Okay. Find a minimum weight edge, E. I need to find out a minimum cost edge, E, among all the edges. Among all the edges, I need to find out the minimum weighted edge. I need to find out a minimum weighted edge, okay, such that V is in the VT. The first vertex, whatever the edge I am selecting, first vertex should be in VT. What is VT? Set of visited vertices, and U should be in the set of unvisited vertices. How to find out a set of unvisited vertices? It is nothing but what is my V? It is a set of all the vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, what is my V? It is 1, 2, 3, 4. Set of all the vertices. Okay. Now, what is my VT? VT is a set of visited vertex. Which is a set of visited vertex? 1. So, it is 1, 2, 3 minus 1 is nothing but 2, 3, 4. Getting my point? So, what is this? So, set of all the vertices minus set of visited vertex. Visited vertex is 1. Therefore, what is the remaining vertex? 2, 3, 4. So, I need to find out the minimum cost edge such that the first vertex should be visited vertex. This is only the vertex till now it is visited. Okay. 1. Now, I have to find out the U. U can be 3. U can be 4. U can be 2. So, whatever it is. You may be having one more vertex like this. Okay. It may be a fun. Such that there should be an edge from 1 to U. So, 1 to 3 I am having. 1 to 4 we are having. 1 to 2 we are having. So, among these three vertices, I need to find out the minimum weighted edge among all the edges. Among all these three edges. 1 to 3, 1 to 4 and 1 to 2, we need to find out a minimum weighted edge. So, that is minimum weighted edge in this example is 1 to 3. So, we have selected 1, 3. So, in this, this is a U and this is U and this is an V. Okay. Then, after finding this minimum weighted edge, what we need to do? Add that vertex U. U means 3 to the set of visited vertex. What was the previous set of visited vertex? 1. Okay, previous set of the visited vertex was 1. Now, union. The new vertex what we have selected, that is 3. Now, 3 is also a visited vertex. 1 is also visited vertex. 3 is also a visited vertex. Okay, now VT, that is set of visited vertexes 1 and 3. Now, ET was initially null. Now, include the edge what you have selected, that is nothing but 1, 3. So, that edge will be included in the ET. 1, 3 is the edge what we have included and the number vertices visited are 1 and 3. Okay. Then, okay, you hear, this will be and returned at the end. Return ET is at the end, not now it is. Okay. Maybe here. For I is equal to open and close. Okay. It is there in my notes, you go through. So, that is, this is an algorithm. For an, now again it will come to this one. Again when I will go here, it is 2 to 3. It is incremented. Again, you need to find out a minimum cost ratio. Now, which are the visited vertices? 1 and the 3 are the visited. Which are unvisited? 4, 5, 2. 4, 5, 2 are unvisited vertices. Which are the visited vertices? 1 and 3 are the visited vertices. Now, for this 1 and 3, you need to identify the edge, which is a minimum. So, 1 to 3 is there. 1 to 4 is there. With the edge cost of 3 and 2. And 3 to 4 is also there with a cost of 4. Which is the minimum among this 3, 2 and 4? 2 is the minimum. So, the next vertex that will be included is the 4. And the next edge that will be included is which one? 1 to 4. 1 to 4. Like this it will continue until unless we will get all the vertices of an given graph. So, till all the vertices of a given graph, this will be an repeated. So, write this is a standard algorithm for an Prim's. Usually in the Padma Reddy and all, you are having a different algorithm for the Prim's and the Kruskal. Don't go through that one. Go through this is a standard algorithm what we are having for the Prim's. Because usually during the correction, so we will keep the scheme with us. So, usually the schemes will have the standard algorithms which will be there in the prescribed textbook. Therefore, go through this algorithm. Okay. It's very simple. You need to find out the minimum cost edge. U, E is equal to V, U such that V is a visited vertex. U is an unvisited vertex. After finding that one, add that U to the visited vertex. Add that U to the visited vertex VT. Okay. And add that edge to the set of the edges. So, finally, what is the output of this Prim's algorithm? The output of the Prim's algorithm is nothing but this one. Means set of the edges, ET. The output of the Prim's is not a diagram. Okay, remember this point. Output of this Prim's or a Kruskal, whichever you consider, output is not a diagram with a circle and edges. What is the output? It is a set of the edges which will construct your minimum spanning tree. So this is about Prim's algorithm and tracing, how to trace the problem. Okay, now come to the what is the time complexity of this one. It's very simple. What is the time complexity of a Prim's algorithm? What is the input for the Prim's algorithm? Input for the Prim's algorithm is nothing but a graph. So how the graph will be represented? The graph will be represented by using matrix. Okay. What is the input for this graph? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. 1 to 2. Diagonal elements are zeros. 1 to 2 is 3. 1 to 3 is 1. 1 to 4 is 2. This is infinity. Infinity usually will represent it with a largest number in your lab program like 999. Okay, it indicate what? Infinity. Then 2 to 1 is 3 and 2 to 2 is 0. 2 to 3 is 999. Infinity. 999 indicate infinity. And 2 to 4 is nothing but again infinity. And 2 to 5 is 5. Like this you will enter the matrix. So, what is the time complexity of a Prim's algorithm? So, in order to implement this Prim's algorithm, I should go through each and every entry of the matrix. Correct or not? So, we should go through each and every entry of your matrix. Then, obviously, what is an time complexity? N square. Got it. N is nothing but the N cross N is nothing but the size of your number of vertices. N indicate what? 4 means 4 cross 4, 5 means 5 cross 5, 6 means 6 cross 6, like that. N represent a number of the vertices. Obviously, it is N square. Obviously, the time complexity of your Prim's algorithm, all the algorithms, whichever is using the graph concept, their time complexity will be an N square. Because we need to go through each and every entry of your matrix. Okay, thank you.